Hello, hello everyone, I'm Zahara. In this video we're going to take a look at the Zinogre armor set, its skills, what the skills do, for which weapons these skills are useful, what materials we need to craft the set, and where to get these materials. A quick note before we start, this is the low rank set. If you're looking for the high rank set, please check the description below. I'm planning on making videos of all the monster sets in this game, so if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. Also, if this video was useful in any way, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like or a comment. This way, hopefully more people will see these videos. With that being said, let's get started. So here we have a good look at the Zinogre armor set. I really like this set, especially the female version. The male version is also really, really nice. Just gonna rotate it a little bit so you have a good look at the front and the back. It's a really cool set. So Zinogre was introduced in Monster Hunter Portable Turret. I already said it in other videos, but Monster Hunter Portable Turret and Monster Hunter Rise, they share a lot of DNA. So again, I'm really happy that this monster and this set made it in this game. So let's take a look at what skills you will get with this set. With the set you will get Latent Power level 3, Critical Eye level 2, and Constitution level 3. Okay, so Latent Power is described really bad, really, really bad. The description says the following. Temporarily increases infinity and reduces stamina depletion when certain conditions are met. Again, really vague. So how can you activate this skill? In real, it's quite easy. The only thing that you need to do to activate this skill is that a monster spots you. So when a monster sees you, after 2 minutes and 45 seconds, this skill will activate. It being Latent Power level 3, you will get 30% extra infinity, and your stamina depletion will go down with 50%. This will last for 2 minutes, and then this buff will go away. The buff will reactivate again after 2 minutes and 45 seconds. However, this skill will activate a little bit faster if you attack the monster. Gaijin Hunter had a really interesting video explaining this skill a lot better than I ever could, so I'm just gonna leave a link to his video in the description if you want to learn more about it. Moving on to Critical Eye level 2, which will give you a 10% extra infinity. If you don't know what infinity is the chance of you landing a critical hit. And the last skill, which is Constitution level 3, will reduce your stamina consumption by 30% while rolling or blocking attacks. Let's quickly look at the stats. This set has 3 in fire, minus 2 in water, 23 in thunder, minus 17 in ice, 8 in dragon, and you start with 140 defense. So which weapons would I recommend this set? I think that this set can be used for pretty much all the weapons. You will have Critical Eye, which is always good to have, it's extra damage. Constitution, again, everyone needs to roll or block, so it's also nice to have. Latent Power, they say that it doesn't work that good for the bowgun, but still, you will have half of the time this buff activated, which is pretty good. So yeah, I think that you can use this set for pretty much all the weapons. Plus you get the added bonus of having one of the nicer sets in the game. To craft this set, you will need the following. 2 Zinogre Horns, 6 Zinogre Shock Furs, 1 Vogerbock, 10 Zinogre Shells, 4 Zinogre Claws, 1 Zinogre Plate, and 1 Zinogre Tail. Let's quickly look how to get all these materials. To get the Zinogre Horn, you will need to break the head. To get the Zinogre Claw, you will need to break the claw. To get the Zinogre Tail, you will need to cut the tail. To get the Zinogre Shock Fur and the Vogerbock, your best options are to get the shiny drops. The Vogerbock only has a 20% chance of dropping this way, which is the biggest chance of getting it. So just use the riding mechanic and hit Zinogre a few times with another monster and hope that you get it that way. And then the hardest thing to get is the Zinogre Plate. The best way to get this is by breaking the horn, which will give you a 3% chance of getting it, and then capturing the monster, which will give you a 2% chance of getting it. And then you will also need 2 Electro Sacks. You can get this by fighting Kazu. The best way to get it is by capturing him. 2 Bashura Furs, which you can get by hunting the Bashura. Then you also need 2 Monster Man Pluses. You can get this by hunting the Great Izutsu, the Great Baggy, or the Great Waggy. And the last thing that you will need is 3 Thunderbugs. Probably you have this already laying around. In case that you don't have it laying around, you can go to your farm and get it that way. Anyway, that's all for the set. Thank you so much for watching and have a good hunt.